training video on FAD cost and benefit calculation. Califico project managers practiced the FAD cost and user fee calculation during second year of the project in 2014. The second project manager meeting held 2nd to 3rd June 2015 suggested to have a FAD cost and benefit calculation workshop during early 2016. After having successfully deployed the FADs in 6 countries, first period of the project, the determination of the sustainability of the FAD fishery in your field is one of the important issues, which should be qualitatively evaluated. Project managers should have knowledge to evaluate FAD activity and guide the FAD group for their future development. There are 2 main objectives. The first, to be able to calculate FAD costs and benefit. The second is to be able to calculate ideal FAD user fee. There are 3 main presentations in this video. The first, the FAD cost calculation. The second, FAD benefit calculation. And the last, third, FAD user fee calculation.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Thank you. My name is Hayao Matsui, and I'm from Japan as a JICA intern. I'm from Hiroshima University. I'm doing a master's student there. So this time, I'm very happy to have opportunity to make a presentation to you about FAD cost calculation. So, yeah. Also, if you have any questions, please ask me. Okay, so let's proceed. So this is outline. So first of all, why should we do cost calculation? Under fisheries participatory FAD fishery management, it is essential for FAD fish users to establish workable and practical fund generation system for replacement and repair of FADs. So now Califico providing FAD materials and like installing FAD in many countries. But after the Califico project finished, fishers should maintain the FAD for the sustainable FAD using. Then for that maintenance, maybe some user fee, some money has to be collected for the maintenance. So to calculate FAD user fee, we are now trying to calculate the FAD cost. So before the cost calculation, please imagine what should we do before using FAD? I mean, by the time we can use the FAD for the fishing, so what do we have to prepare, please? So first of all, we should buy materials for the FAD, and for that material, as a material, buoy, rope, sandbag, and something like that, we should buy. So second, after purchasing the material, also we need to construct FAD. Then for that time, also some people can get together and cooperate to construct the FAD. So manpower should be needed for the construction. After the construction, we go to the deployment for the FAD. Then for the deployment, we should consider these 3 items. First item is transportation. That means, for example, the place you construct a FAD is not on the port. I mean, if you construct the FAD at your house, we have to transport the FAD from the house to the port. harbor. So transportation fee means that. Then fuel means fuel for the ship, because from the port to the offshore, when the place you deploy the FAD, also you need to transport the FAD by the ship. So at that time, the fuel fee, I mean gasoline, is we have to pay for that. Also, we need some people help to deploy the FAD. So for that, manpower is needed. So after the deploy the FAD, also we should maintain the FAD, because sometimes the big ship comes and the FAD loop will be cut, and at that time we should replace the loop for the FAD. Okay, so also for the maintenance, we should consider fuel, materials, manpower. Fuel means like because we have to go to the sea from the port to maintain the FAD, so fuel is used for that. Then material cost is also we should replace the, for example, rope. We should replace rope, buoys when the material is went to some other place. Also material cost, that means also manpower means also we need to cooperate to maintain the FAD. So manpower cost is that. So okay, so annual cost buffer, I mean in Antigua case, because we want to calculate FAD user fee, we want to collect FAD user fee in per year. So that's why now we calculate annual cost per FAD. Then for the FAD cost, so far as I explained, we should consider material cost, construction cost, deployment cost, and plus maintenance cost. Then this material, construction, deployment cost, the sum of these are FAD average cost. But here, we should consider like a miscellaneous, okay? Also, we should consider miscellaneous, for example, administration cost, inflation cost, unforeseen. Administration cost means that, for example, when we order FAD materials, sometimes we have to call, so at that time we should pay for that, like a phone call cost. Also when you send a fax, also we have to pay for that. So administration cost like this. Also inflation, because inflation is now Caribbean countries developing more and more. So at that time, because we want to calculate license fee in the next 1 year, so we should consider the next 1 year inflation or FAD materials or yeah, so maybe. So okay, so unforeseen, because we don't know what will happen in the future. So like he's now getting sick on the sea, because for him he's the first time going to the sea. I don't know who he is, but I think yeah, he's having a hard time there at that time. Yeah. Okay, so maybe he thinks that he will not be sick on the boat, but actually he got sick. So we don't know what will happen in the future. That's an example of unforeseen. Yeah, miscellaneous, we should consider important. Okay, so. So annual cost per FAD can be calculated as material cost, construction cost, deployment cost, plus maintenance cost, plus miscellaneous. So finally, we want to calculate total FAD, annual total FAD cost. So also we should consider the number of fats. How many fats, how many government fats are there in that country? So as that case, the number of fats should be multiplied by material, I mean this fat average cost. Material cost, construction cost, development cost. Then here, because in Antigua calculation, we calculate maintenance cost for we calculate maintenance cost for total fat. I mean, these costs are for one fat, but this maintenance cost is for all the fats in that country. So we don't have to divide the number of fats on that maintenance cost, just add it. Okay, so material cost, construction cost, deployment times number of fats plus maintenance, and finally we should consider miscellaneous important part. Then okay, so this is some looks like so complicated, so I like to put sign A, B, C, D, sorry, E, F for each items. So from next, I like to explain how to calculate each items. Okay, so before that, just before that, so in Antigua, I like to explain using Antigua and Barbuda case. So for the data collection, data collection was conducted in February. Then we collect the data from five fat fishermen. Then the data I show from here is the average among five fishermen. So yeah, just remember it. So from now, I'd like to explain how to calculate each item. So first of all, A, material cost. So this is the fat lifespan. So in here, Antigua case, 3.13 years is a fat lifespan. Then because we don't know how, because in Antigua and Barbuda, we deployed the fat in recent years, maybe 1 or 2 years ago. So we asked the five fat fishers to estimate how long does the fat will be last. Then this is the average of the estimated fat lifespan. So for the material cost, I mean for the materials, Antigua is in Antigua fat, these materials are used. Buoy, pressure buoy 300, polysteel 12, polysteel 10, sea straw, swivel, appendage, and sandbags. So, okay, so how to calculate each materials means unit times unit price. Then we can know that each material cost. For example, in the V case, I got 2 units times about 183 equal to about 3,360. Next, please. So, okay, so this is one fat subtotal cost. I mean, sum of each material cost. So sum of these material costs will be this amount. This, so plus, blah, 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 blah. It's about 3,800. So finally, we can get one fat subtotal cost, annual one fat subtotal cost. Then, so this annual cost, we can get subtotal cost divided by fat lifespan. So in Antigua case, this subtotal cost, like about 3,800 3,800 divided by 3.13 equal to about 1,200 as an annual material cost. Okay, so next, I'd like to explain about how to calculate construction cost. So for the construction, we should consider manpower cost. Then this unit means number of people. Unit price means fee for the one person. This days means how long does it take? Like how many days does it take to construct, to complete one FAD? So, because unit, number of people, this is 2-4, but the reason is because this is average value. Because almost fish answer, they need 2 or 3 person for the FAD construction. So that's why this is 2.4. Okay? Then also unit price means, so how much do you charge for the, how much, this means I asked the fishers, how much do you charge for the one day construction at the moment? How much do you charge for the FAD deployment, FAD construction, if you are FAD making professional? This means unit price. Also, please remember, this is one day for the, this is a fee for 1 day. So that means they charge 530 Ishidara in 1 day, one person. Then also this day is also 7.2.7, but yeah, this is also maybe some officials answer, they need to, it takes 2 or 3 days to complete FAD, so that's why this is 2.5. Then, so manpower cost can be calculated unit times, unit price times days. So this time, this times, this times, this. Then finally we can get around 3400 as a manpower cost. Then, for the construction, we only should consider, we only have to consider manpower cost. So this can, this amount can be also one FAD subtotal cost. I mean 34,000 is one FAD subtotal cost. Oh, sorry. 3400. So finally, to get the annual cost, subtotal cost is divided by FAD lifespan, then we can get about 1100 Ishidara as a annual cost, construction cost. So next, I'd like to explain how to calculate deployment cost. As a deployment cost, we should consider transportation cost, fuel cost, and manpower cost. Then, please. So for the transportation cost, it's calculated as unit times unit price. Unit means how many times it takes you need to go, you need transport your FAD to the port, so it is just one time. Then unit price means like a cost for the transportation. Then so in Antigua case, one times about 168. So next is fuel cost. Can be calculated as unit, I mean gallons, times unit price, gasoline price. So fuel cost means fuel cost for the ship when you go to, when you go from port to offshore for the deployment place. So in Antigua case, this is the average amount of gallons. So fishers average use this about 42 gallons for the deployment. Also in Antigua, unit price 11.5. So just this multiply this is about 530. So manpower cost also for the deployment, we need manpower. So unit number of people times unit price fee. Then also this is average value. So I mean, so 33 plus, because yeah, some people answer 3, some people answer 4, so this is average. Then also this is fee, I mean, yeah, charge for one time. So this time this cost for the manpower.
Excuse me, hey. I don't have bottle, what should I do?
Okay, in that case you need to hire best sales for the pub deployment. So in that case, this fuel cost should be calculated as best sale cost. Okay, so unit is one, the unit price means the price cost for best sale, then just please multiply. Okay. Also this manpower cost. Also, yeah, this is also manpower is needed for the when you hire the best sale, so manpower is just it. So one fat subtotal cost is sum of transportation, fuel, manpower cost. So in this case, sum of these, then 1100 is seen as a subtotal. Then finally, annual one fat subtotal cost is subtotal cost divided by lifespan. Then in Antigua case, about 350, around 360 as an annual deployment cost. Okay, so next, I'd like to explain the maintenance cost calculation. So for the maintenance cost, we should consider fuel, material, and manpower cost. Oh, so first of all, in Antigua Barbuda case, fisher doesn't dedicate their trip to maintenance. So fisher maintain the FAD during the fishing trip. Okay, so please remember that. So how to calculate fuel cost? Please. So the fuel cost, because as I said, fisher maintain the FAD during the fishing trip. So please look here. So in this case, so average, so five fishes average use their maintenance time 5.95 hours, maybe almost 1 hour. Yeah. Then also, although they go to the fishing trip 8.8 hours per day. So we should distinguish how much fuel is used for the maintenance time, then also how much fuel is used only for the fishing catch time. So we use this formula. Okay? So fuel cost, unit, gallons times unit price, gasoline price times day. Then so far this includes the fuel for maintenance time and also fishing time. So by multiplying this part, maintenance time divided by fishing hours, then we can get how much fuel used for the maintenance. Okay, so in Antigua case, so we use this value, then finally we get that 290 EC is used for the maintenance, fuel for the maintenance. So next, material. So material cost can be calculated as unit price times day, how many days they go to the fishing for in a year. But in Antigua case, because some fishers was hard to answer how much material cost is used for the one maintenance also they have to answer how many days they go to fishing. So
it's 4 o'clock.
They just answer how much cost in annual. So in this case, we took the average of material cost, total annual cost. I took average annual cost among 5 fishers. That's it. So don't calculate using this formula. So next, manpower cost. Also, so just same, just like same as fuel cost. Also, for the manpower cost, we want to distinguish how much manpower cost is used for the maintenance. Okay, so then we use this formula: unit number of people times unit price, manpower fee times days. Then multiplying this, we can distinguish. Then, for example, unit is also 2.6 people is average. Unit price, this is quite low because some fishers doesn't charge for the manpower, so they answered zero. Then I took an average, so that's why this is quite low. Here also, they maintain 5 times in a year, just the same. Then I finally get 34 EC for the manpower cost. So yeah, total first and total cost is fuel, material, manpower. This is some of this cost is already annual cost, because here we already get annual cost, so we don't have to divide by lifespan. This is directly annual cost. Next, so E, number of FADs. This is easy. Number of FADs means number of governmental FADs. So in Antigua, we already have 7 governmental FADs. So just 7. This is up to now, this is optimal number.
Governmental FAD or Califico FAD?
Califico FAD.
No, this is not governmental. This is the both Fisher and Fisher Division set up FAD. Okay, next.
Okay, so finally, we got... No. So far, we get this A, B, C, D, E. We get these values. So, to get miscellaneous, you want to get base total FAD cost, this value. So, please. So, base total FAD cost is the summing up total material, total construction, total development, plus total maintenance cost. So, this material cost is for one FAD. So, to get the total cost, just this one material cost multiplied by number of FADs, I mean 7. Then we can get this total material cost. Also, this construction development, just like same as this times 7, this times 7, this. The maintenance cost is already for the total. This maintenance cost is already, we get the total cost. Total annual total cost. I mean maintenance cost for all the FADs. So we don't have to multiply the number of FADs. We can put just the same number as it. Then the sum of these items is base total FAD cost. So move on to the miscellaneous, because administration cost we said 10%. Yeah, I mean 10% means administration cost occupy 10% of this amount. Okay, so inflation we said 7%, we get this value, we get this percentage from the invoices for the FAD material cost. We, yeah. Then unforeseen, we said 10%. So each cost is based on the FAD cost times percentage. In Antigua administration cost, maybe 90,000 times 10% is 900. So the also, please next. So annual total FAD subtotal cost is like just summing up administration, inflation, unforeseen. These cost. This is also already annual cost. So we don't have to divide by lifespan. Just some of this. So finally, we get all the items which is necessary for FAD cost calculation. Then please go to. Yeah, so this is the previous slide for the annual total FAD cost calculation. Just material cost plus construction cost plus deployment cost times number of FADs. Because these are one for the one FAD cost, so should be multiplied by number of FADs. This is maintenance cost as well. This is already annual cost, so just sum it plus miscellaneous. Then, so just A plus B plus C times E plus D plus F. Then finally, we get about 24,000 as annual total FAD cost. Yes. Then, yeah, this value will be used to calculate FAD user fee.
Good morning. My name is Misako Ichikawa, a JICA intern student from Soka University in Japan. Today, I'd like to explain FAD benefit calculations. Last Saturday, I deployed to FAD and I took this photo. After presentation, I hope you understand how to calculate daily FAD benefit. Also, during presentation, if you have any questions, please ask us. And also, during presentation, I will ask you many questions, so please listen carefully. This is today's agenda. My presentation can be divided three parts. First, how to calculate daily FAD benefit. Second, example of Antigua fisherman. Third, discussion. Let's move on to the first part. How to calculate daily FAD benefit. Daily FAD benefit equals daily income minus daily operational cost. It looks simple. However, do you know how to calculate daily income and daily operational cost? From now, I will explain it. Daily income equals FAD amount charged per day times price of each point. Daily operational cost equal fixed cost plus running cost plus labor cost. So far, do you have any question? Okay. So to summarize, daily FAD benefit equal daily income minus daily operational cost equal FAD amount charged per day times price of 1 point minus fixed cost, running cost, labor cost. Let's start a question. You can calculate daily FAD benefit from this data. Can anybody try this question? Okay. So this sheet is useful for your calculations. Daily FAD benefit equal daily income minus daily operational cost equal FAD amount charged per day times price of 1 point minus fixed cost, running cost plus labor. So you can put data in this box so you can calculate daily FAD benefit. It's answer. Next, I will explain example of Antigua fisherman. we have conducted semi-structured interview from February 9 to 27 at fishery divisions, harbor and sea. We asked fishermen daily income, fixed cost, running cost, and labor. From now, I will explain Antigua Fisherman A case. This is actual interview sheet from Fisherman A. I asked the fisherman number of FAD, working day per year, share, daily income. So from now, I will explain each category. In order to calculate daily income, I asked the FAD amount, I asked the fisherman FAD amount catch per day and the price of 1 pound. In this case, all fish are same price, so from his data, FAD amount catch per day is 175 pound. Price of 1 pound is 10 each dollars. So in this case, all fish are same price. However, if all fish are different price, you must use another calculation. This is all fish are different price case. If all fish are different price, we must multiply each FAD amount catch per day and the price of 1 pound. Fishermen can get four different types of fish by FAD fishing, such as tuna, mahi-mahi, marine, wahoo. So we must multiply each FAD amount catch per day and the price of 1 pound. Can you understand?
Yes.
Hi. Next talk. In order to calculate daily income, I asked the fisherman number of annual working day. Number of annual working day equal working day per week times working week per years. It's also actual data from fisherman A. Number of annual working day 210. So this photo is a fish pot. Every Thursday we go to the sea to fish pot. It's me. Next. In order to calculate daily income, I asked the fisherman a share. In his case, he is 4 share. Captain 1, crew 2, boat and engine 1. So, share is 4. Can you understand? Hi. Next, fixed cost per day. Fixed cost includes this item, and I will explain each item. Boat fixed per day equal price times unit divided annual working day times expected lifespan times ratio of FAD income to total income. Can you understand why we must multiply ratio of FAD income to total income? Okay, I will explain. Next. We must multiply ratio of FAD income to total income because fisherman A is engaging not only FAD fishing but also another type of fishing, such as conch, fish pot, hand line, net fishing. So he uses his bottle for not only FAD but also another type of fishing. So this pie graph shows income ratio of fisherman A. As you can see, FAD income occupies 25% of his total income. So in order to calculate more correct data, we must multiply ratio of FAD income to total income. Can you understand?
Yes.
Engine fixed cost per day equal price times unit divided annual working day times expected lifespan times ratio of FAD income to total income. Those are actual data from fisherman A. Price is 25,000. Unit is 1. Annual working day is 210 days. Expected lifespan is 10 years. Ratio of FAD income to total income is 0.25. So 12 EC dollars engine fixed cost per day. To multiply 0.25, it's fixed engine fixed cost for only FAD fishing. Next, trolling line fixed cost per day. Trolling line fixed cost per day equal price times unit divided annual working day times expected lifespan. So do you know we must multiply 1? Because trolling line used for only fat fishing, so we must multiply 1. Can you understand? Yes. It's also actual data from fisherman A. This 0.076 EC dollars trolling line fixed cost per day. Same as previous, we can calculate drop line. Also same as previous, we can calculate hand line by this formula. Next, flare. Flare fixed cost per day equal price times unit divided annual working day times expected lifespan times ratio of FAD income to total income. Also, it's same as previous. Can you?
Yes. Hi. What is the manufacturer for years?
Yes, actually, manufacturer for years is a fisherman can use flare for years, but in Antigua case, a fisherman cannot get a new one, so expected lifespan is 1 year. Next, quiz. I hope you already understand how to calculate fixed cost per day. So I want to ask life jacket fixed cost per day. It's also actual data from fisherman A. You can calculate life jacket fixed cost per day from those data. Can anybody try this question? This sheet is useful for your calculation. Its answer 0.28 is life jacket fixed cost per day for only fat fishing. It's me when we deploy the fat. Next, VHF fixed cost per day equal price times unit divided annual working day times expected lifespan times ratio of FAD income to total income. So it's almost same as previous. Can you understand?
Yes.
Okay, next, GPS fixed cost per day. It's also same as previous. Can you understand?
Yes.
Next, boat maintenance fixed cost per day. It's little bit different from previous. So boat maintenance fixed cost per day equal price times per year divided annual working day times ratio of FAD income to total income. It's also actual data from fisherman A. Price is 300 EC dollars times per year is 2. It's twice a month. He maintains his boat twice a month.
Twice a year.
So annual working day is 210 days. Ratio of FAD income to total income is 0.25. So it's 2.86 EC dollars for boat maintenance fixed cost per day. 0.72 EC dollars boat maintenance fixed cost per day for only fat fishing. I hope you understand how to calculate boat maintenance cost. So let's try quiz engine maintenance fixed cost per day. So you can calculate engine maintenance fixed cost per day from those data. Can anybody try this question? Hi. This sheet is useful for your calculation. So answer is 11.430 EC dollar. It's engine maintenance fixed cost for fat fishing. We already calculated all item. When we sum all item, we can calculate fixed cost per day for fat fishing. In his case, 21 EC dollars fixed cost per day for FAD fishing. Next, running cost per day for FAD fishing. It's an old item. I will explain each item. Next. Fuel running cost per day equal price times gallon. Price is 12 EC dollar, gallon is 10, so 120 EC dollar is fuel running cost per day. Next, engine oil running cost per day. Engine oil running cost per day equal price times gallon. Actually, in his case, his engine is 4-stroke engine. Fishermen who use 4-stroke engine do not use engine oil. However, engine oil cost is included engine maintenance cost. Next, ice. Same as previous, you can calculate ice running cost per day equal price times basket. Form is also same as previous. Also same as before. That we already calculate all item. When we sum all item, we can calculate landing cost, total landing cost per day for FAD fishing. In his case, 250 EC dollars landing cost per day for FAD fishing. Next, labor is for share case. Labor equal daily income minus fuel minus engine oil minus data divided number of share. It's also actual data from fisherman. 392.5 is one share. So in his case, he used two crew, so he needed to pay this much of 785 EC dollars. This amount. So to summarize, labor cost is 785 EC dollars. To summarize, we already calculated fisherman A data, what amount catch per day, price of 1 pound, fixed cost per day, running cost per day, labor. So we can calculate daily FAD benefit for fisherman A. Daily FAD benefit equal daily income minus daily operational cost equal FAD amount catch per day times price of 1 pound minus fixed cost, running cost plus labor. Fisherman A daily FAD benefit. So to summarize, daily income equal FAD amount catch per day times price of each pound. Operational cost per day equal fixed cost plus running cost plus labor. So daily FAD benefit equal daily income minus operational cost per day. Can you understand?
Yes.
Hi. There are example from Antigua Fisherman.
Hiroi-san,
explain this graph.
Okay, good morning once again, everybody. As Misako would have explained, the most of the data that she would have presented earlier is from Fisherman A. And when you look at the daily benefit, it would appear as if Fisherman A is making less money than the other three fishers in this scenario. However, what we need to remember is that Fisherman A, his daily benefit, as shown here, is only 25% of his total daily benefit, because he's not only doing FAD, but he's doing other fishing activities. So if you want to get an idea as to his total income, you would have to multiply this figure by 4 to get 100% of his daily income. Now, in the other slides, you would realize that there are some differences in terms of the operation and running costs. For example, Fisherman A, he has a smaller boat, a 25-foot trirang, with a single 4-stroke 100 horsepower engine, and the distance from his operational base to the FADS is somewhere in the range of 10 to 12 nautical miles. When you go to the other end of the scale now, Fisherman D has a boat that is 30 feet in length, a much heavier vessel with twin 250 horsepower four-stroke engines. And his distance from his operational base to the FADS sometime maybe between 25 and 40 miles. So a round trip for him may cost him almost $1,000 in fuel, whereas Fisherman A, his running cost for fuel is somewhere in the region of $120. These two fishers also, Fisherman B, he's the captain of the boat, not the owner. And their way of calculating the labor costs may be different. For example, one would have mentioned that in the interviews that Hayao and Misako would have had during February, that in calculating the labor costs, if he goes fishing with a professional FAD fisher, then he will pay the fisher a third of the profits. So this would be after they would have calculated all the expense, the monies that is left, the other fisher would get a third of that. On the other hand, if he went fishing with a rookie or a trainee on board, then he would pay him a fixed salary somewhere in the region of $150 to $250 depending on the overall catch. So here you have it. The breakdown for Fisherman A, B, C, and D based on the information collected over almost a 1 month period in Antigua and Barbuda. Thank you very much.
Let's move on to final part, discussion. Thank you listening.
Okay, so finally, we can calculate FAD user fee. We can proceed to FAD user fee calculation. Outline, just do it. So, how to calculate user fee? I mean, so in Antigua case, we are going to collect user fee for per boat. So, annual total FAD cost divided by number of boats, then we can get FAD user fee per boat. This is just notification. Number of boats is boat using FAD. Okay, so, so in Antigua Barbuda case, total FAD, annual total FAD cost, we already get about 24,000. Number of boats, currently 12 boats is using FAD. So just this divided by this, then we can get about 2,000 for the FAD user fee per boat. Yeah. Then, so Antigua case, this is, yeah. Finished. Okay, so I'd like to hear what is ID FAD user fee in your country. Yeah, after the calculation, then. So in Antigua case, annual FAD user fee is 2,000 per boat. Then, so just a comparison with FAD daily benefit. Fisherman A case, he earns 700 EC one day using FAD. Also, otherwise, on the other hand, Fisherman D case, he earns 2,400 EC in a day using FAD. So yeah, in Fisherman A case, if he goes the first fishing 4 days, he can compensate this amount. But in fisherman D case, he can compensate this amount for one day. So, yeah, so what implication we can get from this comparison? Okay, so what implication can we get?
Calm down, Somo.
This is my great boss, Ishida-san. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Let's do the discussion. The results show annual 7 FADs in the Antigua and Barbuda water cost around $25,000. When you look at the FAD user fee per boat, there are 12 boats using these 7 FADs. So $25,000 divided 12 equals $2,080. On the other hand, a daily FAD benefit from the Fisher A in case, in the Fisher A case, about $700. So he works 210 days per year. His FAD benefits could be $145,000 per year. So you need to look at this $2,000 and $145,000 to compare. This is 1.5% from the benefit that you can get from FAD fishing. Please take these informations to your original countries and discuss with the fisher group for further your discussions. Now you have knowledge to evaluate your FAD activity. Please guide your FAD group for the further your FAD development as FAD fishery co-management. Thank you very much and congratulations.
Six weeks every 3 months.